The unveiling of the Ferrari SF-23 has raised a lot of discussion regarding its inlet duct on either side of the car that is below the radiator intake, linking this ducting to an outlet on top of the sidepod. So here is another angle to why Ferrari is doing this. To start off, the inlet is situated in a crucial area with recent Formula 1 car aerodynamics, and that is the sidepod forward dimensions expansion point, where air is entrapped by the undercut to create a powerful side draft or outwash, forced wide to further strengthen airflow shredding the floor edges. This also further enhances the ability of the sidepod to draw air downwards from the top. Other teams make no qualms on their design, expressing this fundamental, especially in 2023. So why would Ferrari sacrifice their undercut performance that will affect their sidepod performance? An expansion of an object creates positive pressure buildup at the forwardmost area, and this pressure is also influenced by the continuously expanded dimension behind it. Having an intake in the forwardmost point will result in a very good performance for said intake. Good performance here also means the rest of the airflow will be affected, but also means airflow coming off this intake will be very effective. So with such aerodynamic fundamental, why waste an opportunity to use this to blow the top deck of the SF-23's sidepod? The outlet is also placed in an area where it does not seem plausible to have a powerful blast of air have an aerodynamic impact in terms of influencing downforce performance. This is because it is placed deep within the top sidepod indentation, which is counterintuitive as those indentations are designed to influence more air downwards towards the SF-23's main aerodynamic components, such as its rear wing. Maybe this is also why the indentation is not as aggressive as previous iterations, because this would make it even more of a contradiction. Having ducting in this area will not help influence this downdraft. Just to add more question marks is that its flow path is directly in line with the engine cover louvered ventilation, which is not ideal to improve aerodynamic downforce performance with high velocity airflow. However, this is where it begins to make some sense. Since last season, all Ferrari powered cars have very large cooling intakes. This is a stark contrast to pre-2022 Formula 1 cars or pre-ground effect cars, where they even seem to be a race amongst all Formula 1 cars as to who could make the smallest radiator cooling intake on the sidepod, Ferrari included. A homage to this is the still minimalist approach used by Mercedes-AMG on both their W13 and also W14. Put these pieces together, that it may seem plausible that this duct is there to further cool the SF-23's power plant. Could it be a method that reduces drag yet maintains good cooling properties as it bypasses the radiator yet influences it via the louvers? Here is one theory. This ducting is there because Ferrari's new power plant requires even more performance from the heat exchangers. With few limited purees, Ferrari may have found a way to run their engines at an extremely high air-fuel ratio, and this is also a race for engine thermal efficiency. Remember that these are the teams that went as far as running their engines on ultra-thick friction material so they could burn up all their oil at race pace until the end of a race and then keep those engines for another two or three races.
They were burning the oil as additional fuel so they could run the cars harder beyond the FIA allocated fuel limit.
After the crackdown on oil burning, maybe this is an area where Ferrari development has aimed at. Previous iterations of running an engine hot in Formula 1 contradicts this, as those engines would run perfectly in very high temperatures to gain an aerodynamic advantage, and that is being able to run smaller radiators. Not quite hot combustion, but a very hot engine. A lot of work must have gone through on the tolerances engineered on those engines and the engineering required on the material's heat expansion rate. This time it seems it is the other way around, with these Ferrari-powered engines running very hot that they require even more ventilation than their peers, to a point of sacrificing overall aerodynamic performance. However, for qualifying, could run less fuel and gain a weight advantage.